With the planes animated, you are now ready to create the ghosting effect. If you haven't saved your file earlier and you need to catch up, you can use the file name docfightanimated.max you downloaded for this tutorial. Select the bomber plane. You will start with that one. Go to about frame 120 to get a better look at the plane. With the bomber selected, choose Tools, Snapshot. A dialog appears. You can use the single mode to create a copy, instance, reference, or simply a mesh duplicate at the current frame. Set the option to single, copy, and click OK. Scrub the animation. Note that you now have a non-animated copy of the bomber matching the object's position, rotation, scale, and shape at frame 120. Select that duplicate and delete it. Select the bomber again and go back to the snapshot tool. This time, set the mode to range and the clone method to mesh. Mesh mode collapses the duplicates into simple editable meshes, reducing calculation times in case the original object has many modifiers applied to it. Copy, reference, and instance modes would retain the modifier stack on the duplicates. This is not the case here, as the bomber is simply an editable poly, but keep that fact in mind as you work on your own projects. The next important value to enter is the number of duplicates you want to use. You may need some trial and error values here before you get it right. Type in 15 copies and leave the from and to values to encompass the whole animation. Click OK to create the duplicates. 15 clones have been created displaying the flight of the bomber. There are a few changes you can bring to this. First, it seems there may be a few too many copies. You can probably get by with about 12. Second, you may consider you don't need a duplicate at frame 0 where the original bomber starts up. Press Ctrl Z to undo the snapshot duplicates. With the bomber still selected, use the snapshot tool again. This time, specify 12 copies and set them to start at around frame 35. As always, feel free to experiment with your own values. Once you are satisfied, use the Select from Scene dialog, H on the keyboard, to select all the clones. They should be labeled Bomber 1 through Bomber 12. Apply a semi-transparent material to them. A red material is already available in the Slate Material Editor. This is the same material already applied to the path. Now do the same with the fighter plane. Select the fighter and apply the snapshot tool to it. You probably need more than 12 duplicates, so try it with 16 and start them off at frame 20. Once you're happy with the results, select all duplicates and assign the blue transparent material to them. Render a frame to see the results. Even with a single image rendered, the ghosting effect makes it easy to recognize the flight of the planes. In the next scenario, you'll learn to animate the visibility of the ghosting effect to make the clones appear one after another.